Assalamu alaikum. Gaming Noodle here. Can you feel it? That's right, we're almost done. Almost there. Now, where we left off is in this room with Azrael. We're gonna have to run around and look for these two portals. One is right on the floor and one is to the side. Remember to charge up your shots. Don't just shoot to make the portals, charge them up. Hold the button down to charge it, and then shoot. And what will that do? Well, it's going to give you a huge kick when you exit the portal. And that's what you need. And if you can't do that, well, you're not even going to get to this room here. There is an artifact that we're going to need, so go ahead and shoot that portal at the ceiling, and then this one here. As soon as you go through, hit to the side, so that you glide onto this higher platform, and we can get that lovely little artifact. Now this next bit might get a bit confusing, but don't worry, just follow what I'm doing. Go ahead and cancel out both of these. What we're going to do is, we're going to hit the first portal that comes up here. There it is. Now you turn around and make a portal on this one. Now, you have to time this one. You're going to see another portal come up. You have to time it so that just as it's coming into view, you throw, you shoot. And you'll make a portal. Once you do that, you can jump through and get to the other side. Perfect. And once you get to the other side, go ahead and jump all the way down, because we need to get here. Go ahead and follow what I'm doing here. That's the only way to get across to this next bit. And then we're going to need to make a portal in on that wall that's closest to us. I'm not sure why I'm not doing it. There we go. Now what we're going to need to do is, there is a red crystal wall that's blocking the way that we can't actually see yet, but it is there. You see where that rotating slab of rock is turning? When the portal you made is facing to the right, it's going to be facing where the actual red block is, and that's when you need to throw this into the portal we've made to destroy it. So you just have to time it right, which I kind of failed at, but there you go. Now it's destroyed, and we just have to wait for it to go all the way back around so we can actually now jump in. You may be wondering why we're doing this. It's actually to get an abyssal armor piece, I think. Let me see what is in here. My memory fades. Yes, it is. It's an abyssal armor piece. I think that's like, I think there's only one left, if my memory serves correct. Go ahead and wait for it to turn back around and jump back in. We're gonna have to readjust our portals now. Go ahead and cancel that. Cancel it again, and then shoot the first one onto the rock slab, and then the second one obviously on this one, the one closest to us, and then jump through once you know it's safe to, when it's facing the right way. We're gonna need to do what I just did there, and we're just gonna make a straight portal to the bomb again. Now we just can throw it straight through and jump in with it. Boom, 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 boom. Thank you, Mr. Cameraman. So go ahead and jump through, and we're going to be going all the way up the steps. All the way up. Run, 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 run. Long, winding stairs. looks like an Ocarina of Time before the final boss. Ganondorf on his piano. Right, make a portal on the new one that we just made. And we're gonna zoom all the way up. What's up here? Well, I think you know. It's the key, isn't it? There it is. Okay, now that we have this key, we need to go back to the main room where Azrael is. So go ahead and just copy what I'm doing here by cancelling these out. We're going to be throwing one onto the moving slab, and then one on the side. When you see the portal come up on the screen, you quickly shoot it again. And now we can get through. Basically, the locked door is in the main room of Azrael's, I think, so now that we're back here already, it's pretty quick. We have to jump onto the moving platform. I missed my opportunity there, so I just gotta wait a bit. So much waiting. But again, this is the easiest out of all three. You know, when getting power back to all the crystals, the last one is probably one of the more relaxing ones, kind of, if you know what to do. It's very easy. Go ahead and jump across, make your way until you get to the highest possible platform you can. And go ahead and go through the door. This is going to lead us on our way to the mini-boss. Although we should be going into an outdoor area first, like we have with the other ones. Boss fight. No, not boss fight, just normal fight. There should be, there might be some mobs. We could do some elevator music, couldn't we? Go ahead and kill these. We got some greenies. The greenies are just as easy. I wouldn't, on this section, just kill them as you would. I would save your rage, so don't turn into a balrog, because there's going to be much tougher fights coming up. So really don't want to be wasting the rage here. Oh, I actually used some of my wrath. Surprised even myself. And that should be it. Oh, this elevator ride is taking forever. I like to inspect War when there's nothing else to do. I just look at his character design and I look at the model. Look at all the details. So cool. Yes. I have a few fights here. Again, it really shouldn't be a problem. There are going to be some of those poison monsters, so make sure that you have your boomerang ready so that you can get rid of the poison. There it is. Dodge, 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 smack, smack, dodge. Oh, that took a lot of health. That died very fast. Surprise me. Yeah, don't be near it, it's gonna explode. Why bother to block? You know you're gonna die anyway. Just make it easier for the both of us. Okay, It's another one of these poison mobs. You can make quick work of it, I'm sure. And it's still not over. We've got a big guy here. But you have plenty of space. You shouldn't have a problem with him. Again, very avoidable attacks. There's huge startup animations, so you can easily see it coming. There's no real excuse. Especially when it's just one. And I get hit. There's no excuse to die and not get hit. Let me change that. Its mace drops, whatever it is, its weapon, because I guess when it flies in the air and it slams down, it will hurt you if it touches you. Alright, I think you know the drill by now. Go ahead and hit that first one. Now, when you hit the second one, watch out for that. Go ahead and charge it one more time. Then you're going to need to grab the bomb that's from there with the hookshot, and you're going to throw it through the portal when you see those red crystals. I got a bit impatient and I jumped immediately, and I almost died because the platform started moving again. Luckily I didn't. But now we've got another fight. Again, these ones now, the fights that we're getting now, look, we've got poison and big guy. The combos get more and more kind of annoying, so you have to be very careful. If you want to go ahead and use your rage like I'm doing, go ahead and do it now, because there's really no better time to use it. Yeah, these are basically the hardest parts of this dungeon now. These one few sections where the mobs spawn. So just dispatch them as quick as you can and get past here. That shield's pretty cool, isn't it? I like it. With the green skull face on it. I could use that on my paladin in WoW. Graciously put there for us, because they knew, hey, you might be in trouble, so we'll put some chests in this area for you. And we're still not done, as you can see. There is yet more. Again, try your best if you can to get more rage and then turn to a Balrog immediately. Two of these guys can be very tricky. Look at that, I'm almost dead. It's pretty dangerous. Very, very dangerous combo. Luckily they are pretty slow, so you can choose when to rush in to do some damage. As you can see, as soon as I got the rage, I'm going for the Balrog and just trying to kill them as quick as I can. It's way too dangerous to do it normally for me. I didn't want to waste time by dying or anything. And that was basically it. That's probably the hardest it's going to get in the rest of the game. Because to be honest, even the last boss fight, like, of the entire game, it's not Straga, by the way. Straga is the end boss for this dungeon, but it's not the final boss of the game. And the final boss is not necessarily difficult, but it is fun, and I think that's important. It's very cool, and it's very fun to play. So it's a good boss fight, I think. I enjoyed it a lot. It was very kind of, it was spectacular the way it was done. Like, it looked like a movie in a way, kind of. It was really cool. You'll get to see it soon. But yeah, go ahead and first, when you go in this room, you use the portals, and then you hit that to make the water go from one side, it drains through the portal into the other side. And then we're going to travel across again to the left side, and we can swim across now. So we can reach this contraption. And once you've done so, you're going to see the room change a bit. Those things have locked on, so okay, go ahead and jump across again. Go through that portal and you can get another artifact. Just a little thing not to miss. And what we're going to want to do is, if you want to get that chest that's over there, I'm going to go get it. Souls are souls. But we're going to go up these stairs and we're going to hit this contraption. What it's going to do is it's going to turn the pillar around. And now it's going to reveal something. It's going to reveal a porthole if you run around again. So go ahead and come around and you will see. There it is. So go ahead and use your gun. And we are going to be jumping through again. And it's going to let us get to this area where we can now travel upwards. Or is it downwards? Let me see. It is upwards. We are now at the third mini-boss, which is like the other two mini-bosses, but again, the actual portals that are situated around the room are slightly different. They are going to be on the floor and walls. But you'll get to see how I do it, and if you want, you can do it like that too. Here we are. So again, remember, when you're using your gun, you have to press it and hold it to charge it up. If you don't charge it, you won't get enough lift. So go ahead and use it on two of those portals, one of them being a higher up one, because you need that height to reach the top of it. So go ahead and wait for it to stop near you, near your wall, wherever you're using the portals, and you can go ahead and then jump through and disable it like I'm doing here. As soon as you attack it and then it gets back up again, go ahead and use your portals. Be quick. Jump in. You can avoid damage and yep, jump on top and do that damage. You just have to rinse and repeat. This is the third and final mini boss, so take your time if you have to. Try not to die. The thing is, when it does hit you, it hits you a lot and you will probably die in like a few hits if you're not careful, so just be careful with that. And that should be it. That was the third time doing it. One slice, there we go. Prompt with the B button. And now it's a simple solution. We just have to do what we did before. Now that we've freed the energy from this room, we have to now take that energy all the way back to Azrael. So go ahead and use your gun on that first one before you jump down, and then again on the second that's available to you. And it's actually made a new path which you can now go down. Oh, I see an orb that we must fill with energy. So go ahead and use your gun here, and then you can see the second one through this orb. So go ahead and shoot through and it will work. It's pretty crazy, it's great, I like that. I may try and actually play the portal games, if that's where they got it from, because it's kind of neat. I like the idea of how this portal gun works. And I did check a few of the videos on YouTube of Portal and Portal 2, and plus I saw that the voice actor Steve Merchant was in it, which was awesome. You know, anything, I'm a huge fan of Ricky Gervais and Steve Merchant, especially Carl Pilkington, hit like a fucking orange. So anything with them in it is sure to be good. I'm positive of that. So I may give the Portal games a go. But the thing is, like, I think that game is nothing but the Portal gun. It's nothing but that kind of puzzle thing. So I'm not sure how much I could enjoy it as a standalone game, but we'll see. It'd be nice to try. So go ahead and charge up each portal how I did it, exactly how I did it. Don't switch up which ones to hit first, which portals to hit first, otherwise it won't work. There is a specific way to do it, and I know how to do it. That's why I made these videos. You know, I'm doing it to help you guys. I missed that one. Now I've got to wait again for it to come around, and then once I see the portal, I'll shoot at it. Come on, come on. There it is, go ahead and do it. Once you see it turning back, we can then jump through now. Are we gonna have to fight anything? No! Awesome. That is awesome. That's it. That's basically it. We have done it. We have done the dungeon. Almost. Almost. There's this one room left. Now you see it switched up a bit. There's like a new thing that dropped down. We are gonna get an artifact that's in this room. Also gonna get that green chest, because hey, why not? It's a green chest. We're not gonna be here again. But yeah, after we do this, we've almost finished the game. We are not going to go to the boss straight away. We are going to be going and collecting every single missing piece that's left. Artifacts, you know, Wrath Cores, life shards, everything. We're going to be collecting all of it until we're full 100% complete, and then we're going to face the boss. But go ahead and make your way up like I did here. When you grab this chest, before you go back, go ahead and make a portal on top of that newly lowered pillar thing. What we're going to do is, we're going to jump through, and it's going to lift us to the champion artifact. Perfect. Right, what do we do here? Look around for the portal on this side and go ahead and charge it, and then charge the other side. So both sides of that pillar are charged. Now, what we're going to need to do is, I kind of lost my bearings again. We're going to need to find where the there's like a chrono device. As you can see, we do have to hit that pillar thing to move it, but not yet. We have to go here first, use the chronosphere, as you do. Once everything is slowed down, make your way back and then do what I did before. Get the boomerang out and hit the light on the side and it will turn. Make your way to the door. Go ahead and target both crystals on the side of the door to open it. And by the time that happens, yeah, you'll have charged the orb. Quite a few things happening at once, but it shouldn't be too difficult. And that's basically it. That was really, I think, the last puzzle, really. We're just going to make our way back into Azrael's room, where we're going to free him and we're going to see a video. So I'm going to cut this episode right after that, and then we'll continue on in the next episode to fight Straga, the last of the Chosen, who we have a score to settle with. But that's basically the Black Throne done. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it wasn't too annoying and you didn't pull all your hair out, like I'm sure many did. I know I did when I first played it. But hopefully you followed everything exactly as was shown in the video, and you have managed to get through it to this point where I'm at now. And we can get it done. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and let you watch the movie that's about to happen. All I'm gonna say, oh yeah, first, just in case, when you get into the main room, just wait a second. I didn't wait, I was very impatient. Do not do this. Wait on the platform that you come out on, because there is a portal on the side of these moving platforms that you're going to need to shoot. So now because I was a bit impatient, I have to wait now. So I'm going to be going back onto the platform that I was originally on when we came into the room. As you can see, the portal is going to be coming up now on this bit of stone, so just wait for it. Go ahead and charge up your portal gun, ready for it. There it is, go ahead and use it. Now that we have one done, we still have to charge up one more portal. And as you can see, you can jump down if you'd like, get a better view. And we're going to charge up that final portal that you see down there. And once you do that, you just wait. That's all you have to do. Just wait. I'll see you in the next episode. Go ahead and subscribe if you'd like to. Like, dislike, comment, all that good stuff. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.
Straga awaits.
Looks like you finally outlived your usefulness, Azrael.
And how do you propose to leave the tower once Straga has been dealt with? Straga and the tower are one. Even if you manage to defeat him, you'll be trapped without me.
We need him.
Pray the horseman doesn't make it back alive.